gets to the ball game, he's still dizzy, he's having trouble sitting up, he can't get much fluid or nutrients in him, and we're concerned.
It wasn't good actually to see him at all. He was suffering big time.
It was no doubt that I was going to play. You know, I just knew I wasn't 100%, and I was going to see how my game is going to alter because of that.
And he's probably going to play, and he's going to score 40 points because that's usually what he does when he gets sick.
The Bulls fell behind by 14 early in the first quarter. When Michael Jordan left the game, he'd scored only 4 points.
Well, we're thinking that, hey, you know, this is okay, you know. We're going to be all right. Just keep playing your way through this.
He would just walk very slowly over the bench, you know, and he'd just kind of sit on the bench like he was just exhausted.
During the course of the game, you know, agreement was we'd just check in with one another, you know, and see how he's doing as far as rest stop periods.
Jordan came back to score 17 points in the second quarter, and the Bulls were back in the game.
I think Michael jumped out and surprised him entirely because even though Jerry Sloan said before the game, I expect Michael to play. After they looked at him the first quarter, everybody thought, he's not going to make it tonight.
In one hand, when he's sick, you go, yes, that's good because he's going to play good. But on the other hand, you don't want him to be sick because you know how dangerous it can be.
You know, once I was out there, it didn't take much to rationalize that, you know, I'm out here now, might as well go ahead and get the job done and finish it. And no matter what it takes, just me being on the court as an inspiration to the players.
In the fourth, Jordan added 12 more and hit the critical three-point shot that gave the Bulls a lead they would never surrender.
10 on the shot clock. Pippen backing Hornacek. Here's Jordan from the yes. Michael Jordan from straight away. He looks like he's a boxer just hanging on along the ropes.
They tried to use Hornacek on Scottie Pippen, and we can't allow this to happen. So Scottie took him in the post, Michael dropped him the ball, they sunk to help, Byron sunk to help, and he was guarding Michael, and that just left Michael ready to walk right into that three-pointer. It was just mental fatigue.
How ironic that it was the Jazz who fell victim to the fatigue factor and not Jordan, who looked the part all night.
When the game was over with, and that was the time when I felt that, you know, I can let loose, you know, just let my body recover a little bit because I was, you know, more or less pushing it the whole game.
I told Scottie Pippen that this was one of his greatest games that he's ever played because his defense was all over the court. He took up space for Michael. He helped him out so he wouldn't have to work so hard at the other end. That's when the supposed little brother stepped up and helped the big brother.
Now the big story here tonight, the story concerning Michael Jordan's physical conditions. This Jordan arriving about 2 hours ago, he is suffering from flu-like symptoms, made his way onto the court just moments ago, and as you see right here, looking a bit shaky. He was up all last night, spent all day in bed, did not eat at all, did not go to the shoot-around earlier today, did not practice, so his status is uncertain. Ahmad Rashad and Jim Gray will have more on this as the game progresses. Matt, this on top of the Bulls.
Wearing number 23 at 6'6 from North Carolina, Michael Jordan.
Well, I'll tell you, he's Michael Jordan. That's how he did it. Really, there are probably very few players who would have been able to pull off what Michael did today. I think the first thing he has to do is know that he had the skill to perform, even though he didn't have the strength.
What did you know about Jordan's condition going into the game? What did he look like early, and describe the effort that he put forth with the illness that he had?
First of all, I didn't know he's sick. And I thought he played a great game. Did everybody else know he was sick? I guess I was the last one to know.
How would you compare this defining moment, heroics of Jordan, to what Willis Reed did against the Lakers in the early 70s?
Well, I don't know if it's quite that dramatic. One is sickness, the other's injury, and those are two different things considerably, and Willis pulled himself off a table with a couple of, with the aid of some numbing agents in his legs so that he could go out there and hobble around. Michael, on the other hand, was faced with more illness and, fatigue, nausea.
But the story tonight, Michael Jordan. Stirring performance by Jordan. Guys, I think it'll go down as one of his all-time great performances when you consider the conditions that he was playing with the flu. It looked like he was having trouble standing up at times.